the other side. Caught in a chase, 25 to life. Too late for the other side. Caught in a chase, 25 to life.
Jesus Christ, you the man. You the man, Jesus. We love you. Here we are on scene where Jesus Christ himself has come into central London to speak to his children of the Lord. This is a very proud day in central London, here to bless the wedding between Prince William and Kate, the true founder of the Church of Christianity, our Lord Jesus H. Christ, has come down, and what a handsome fellow he is.
Hello, how long are you?
Beautiful. Thank you.
This is Trafalgar Square. This is where I believe the Love Police will be meeting up on the 29th of April for the big wedding. And the signs are very auspicious. You can tell a certain type of person has been here. Look at this. Da, da, da,
da, da. Man, you people killed Jesus.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Royal Matrix. Your job is to be born, become a British subject, swear allegiance to the Queen, get an education, get a job, pay your tax to the Queen, and then die. Sorry, I thought
What's the problem, sir?
Was Great Britain, not, you know, Nazi Germany or China? Sorry.
Now listen. Look, there's Evensong taking place in King's Chapel. You're going to make this noise throughout Evensong?
Yeah.
How long are you going to be in on this?
As long as I want.
No, you're not.
I am.
I'm going to stop you. You've got Evensong in King's Chapel.
How are you going to stop me?
Oh, you bet I'm going to make sure you're
How?
Ladies, hold on.
Ladies and gentlemen, I must apologise. There are some religious ceremonies going in there. And as we all know, the royal family supports religion. The best way to attain freedom. The gentleman here raises a very valid point. Who gives me the right to stand here and speak my mind? I tell you who.
They speak your mind, but not through a loud hailer.
But this isn't any louder than a bus.
I'm sorry. I've got to get this stopped. There's a free way of
speech. The gentleman does not understand irony. He lives in a country where we respect free speech, and he is running off to get me shut up. So, oh well. The ultimate conspiracy is religion. If you really think that Jesus Christ would support Christianity, you better do some more research. Did Jesus really have a whole entire organized religion worth billions of pounds behind him when he became a Messiah? No. He was a poor guy in the desert. So stop supporting these massive institutions, these big cathedrals and churches and popes and priests and pedophiles and whoever else. Religion is the ultimate conspiracy. Please accept that. And quit your internal dialogue, you're wrong. Okay? Okay. There is nothing anachronistic or old-fashioned about a monarchy. It's very good that we have young boys swear allegiance to a queen as they go and kill people and spread democracy. Only get your information from mainstream media sources. Trust the corporate-controlled news to tell you the truth. Everything is okay. There is nothing more to your life than shopping, fashion, warfare, terrorism, and swine flu. Consume as many material objects as you can. There is nothing more to life. For the men, go to football matches, become a maniac, and for the ladies, buy as much makeup and perfume as you can. Quit nature. Welcome to the artificial world. Do as you are told. Worship the royal family. They are better than you. And it's very good that in a hereditary system, other people's children can be future king but your children will never be future king, because you are a peasant.
Walking towards is good.
Good news. The war rages on in Palestine, Libya, Iraq, Afghanistan. Thousands of people die, but who cares? Prince William and Kate will look amazing on Friday. Worship the blue bloods, worship the monarchy. Know that you are a slave. Your opinion is meaningless. Your job is to work, pay taxes, and then die. But that's okay. The Queen loves you. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Her Majesty's Institute for Brainwashing and Propaganda. I do not see enough Union Jacks or other nationalistic, patriotic instruments of brainwashing here. You peasants need to know that in 5 days' time, the people who are better than you will be getting married, spending your taxpayers' money to distract you from the economy, from losing your houses, losing your jobs, and from the fact that your country is now sending military officers to go and kill Libyans. But hey, who cares? Who cares that 30,000 African children died of starvation today? Who cares that in Iraq, children are being born with mental deformities after British A-10 Thunderbolt aircraft are firing depleted uranium into their villages? Who cares? Who cares? Prince William looks great. Kate Middleton looks fantastic. And in 5 days' time, we can forget all our problems and be nice, obedient British, not citizens, subjects. We can be nice, obedient British subjects and do as we are told. Get our bums glued to the seats, watch the television broadcast, enjoy the pomp and ceremony, enjoy the fact, the irony, that the Queen gets young working class boys to swear allegiance to her as she sends them off to go and kill Arabs for democracy. A monarchy spreading democracy by killing people. It's almost like a Monty Python sketch if it wasn't so murderous. But anyway, don't listen to me. I'm just a crazy guy with a megaphone. Listen to the news. Listen to the television. The monarchy's a wonderful institution. The Queen loves you. They actually consider you equals. They're not blue-blooded. They're normal people. Or are they? At least William is marrying a peasant. So, you know, that's progress. Anyway, enjoy your sunshine and shopping. Don't stand around here listening to me. You're wasting valuable tourism and shopping time. So go and be good consumers. There's nothing more to life. You are a flesh and blood consumer. Uh-oh, here's the police. Careful. Yes. See, I can't talk now. The law's here. Thank you. Enjoy the wedding. It's a very important institution. Very important that in the year 2011, we still have a royal family with 100,000 palaces, billions in the bank, and who are truly the world's biggest landowners on earth. But hey, that's okay. My son will be born and he'll never be king, neither will yours. But that's okay, Prince William's son will be king. It's a very fair system. Have a good day. The royal family is very good for the British economy. But by that logic, so is killing people, because it's great for the arms industry. Oh. Oh, yeah, and one more thing as well. Princess Diana, her death was a little bit dodgy. You know, Muslim boyfriend. You know, son to be future king. You can't have a Muslim stepbrother or half-brother to the future king, can you? No. 5 days' time, the royal wedding will take place. You must be as patriotic and nationalistic as you can. I mean, at least the police have turned up with crowns on their helmets. Where's your Union Jacks, people? Come on, the Blue Bloods are better than you. It's good that you spend all this taxpayers' money to distract yourselves away from war and death and famine and poverty and the economy crashing, losing your houses, losing your jobs. At least for one day, we can all pretend everything is okay as we watch Cinderella play itself out in real life. But unfortunately, the next day, 30,000 African children will die of starvation. The Queen will still be a crazy old woman. Soldiers will still be sent to Arab lands to go and kill people for oil companies. And you will still be peasants. But hey, at least for one day only, we can all be nice royalists and obey and do as we are told. Look, this man in the suit agrees with me. This is why he's standing so close to me. He knows.
You're a good geezer, boy.
All right, man.
Strong man.
Cheers. Oh,
this is just perfect. Look at this. It's like they put this window here for my act. Look at this. This is what you should be spending your money on. This will be worth £5 in 100 years' time. Come on. Bow down to your dear leader. Come on, there's a personality cult we're trying to create here. Look at that, the tourists love this stuff. This is great. This is really what Britain's about. There's no inequality, there's no poverty in this country. There is just Cinderella-type weddings. That's good. Good image to sell to the tourists, yeah. I have to tell you all as well, because I'm here from the British Tourist Board propaganda unit. All of Britain looks like Central Cambridge. Everyone is rich in this country, and everyone loves the royal family. That's how it truly is. Thank you.
Yeah, it's true.
You've got the right to protest on the streets.
Exactly, man. All the best.
You know, brother.
Thank you.
Blessed, man.
Cheers.
What were you just protesting?
Nice. Oh, no, not protesting. Yes.
What were you doing?
We're doing a bit of comedy about the royal wedding. And you've got a lovely display. I don't know if it's your shop.
I work here.
You work here. A lovely display about Prince William. So we're just telling people that they need to buy it.
Oh, right.
Yeah, because, you know, it'll be worth a lot of money soon. £5. See you later.
Okay. I will thank you.
Thank me. Oh, can I have a hug?
Thank you.
I saw you in the distance, so I thought, oh no, is this going to be some kind of
crazy religious
stuff?
No, we're here to do
for him. Just you know, try and get
internal website.
Yeah. Try and get sort of, you know, a diverse sort of image of what goes on in the day, so it's not so people can actually
do a little piece on him.
I want to thank you.
This is actually his camera. I usually bring my own camera, but
okay. I got a loud voice. So. Yeah. Okay.
I can work on it.
Okay, we're rolling. Okay.
Do you want to, first of all, for the record, give us your name and how you'd like us to describe you?
Sure, my name's Charlie Veitch. I'm a 30-year-old anarchist, and my group, the Love Police, we are the world's only anarcho-absurdist activist group and film group. And we use the powers of sarcasm and absurdity to try and speak about very, very difficult subjects to a population which has been, whose consent has been manufactured by what they read, what they see, and by corporate interests in the corporate-controlled media. So we try and hack people's minds for a few moments and create cognitive dissonance in their heads so that they try and decipher the irony and the sarcasm that we're saying to try and maybe think for themselves.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the International Satanist Federation here with Lucifer himself. Ignore Jesus and bunny rabbits and chocolate Easter eggs. What you want is to sign up to the Church of Satan. Cambridge is the hometown of Aleister Crowley, a very high-ranking Freemason and also a Satanist. And what I will do now to show you that there is nothing wrong with Satanism, I will give Satan a hug. See, the dark side ain't that scary.
And take away that freedom like you did to me. Treat them like you don't need them and they ain't worthy of you. Freedom, the same shit that you made me. I'm moving on, forget you. Oh, now I'm special. I ain't feel special when I was with you. All I ever felt was this helplessness. Imprisoned by a selfish bitch. Chew me up and spit me out. I felt for this so many times, it's ridiculous. And still I stick with this. I'm sick of this. But in my sickness and addiction, you're addictive as they get. Evil as they come, vindictive as they make them. My friends keep asking me why I can't just walk away from them. I'm addicted to the pain, the stress, the drama. I'm drawn to, so I guess I'm a mess, cursed and blessed with this.